right. So the rest of our time here in this section is to have some practice time together. I'm going to do a little something to get curious about and come into relationship with our embodiment right now, what's happening in the body. And Balajit will also lead a little practice after that. So emotion. So we're coming into this retreat, the realm of the emotions. And the realm of the emotions, we talked about information, emotions being information. It's giving meaning to the quality of what's happening, and it gives us some guidance. So that's one thing about emotions, and they're felt. Yeah. So the connection between accessing our feeling, our capacity to feel, and being able to work with emotion is very, very linked. And I want to say that often, but the other thing I want to say is that there's reasons why we may not want to feel so much. So I want to really respect our protection mechanisms. Yeah. And there may be actually very skillful reasons to put a boundary on how much feeling is happening, because it's possible to get overwhelmed. Yeah. To the point where, like, it's almost like if you imagine, if we have these different channels of energy flowing and we could burn out a channel, you know, like there's too much coming through and we end up like burning out that channel. That's not so helpful, right? So there's a little bit of pacing around, okay. Everything's happening everywhere all at once, as the movie Everything Everywhere All at Once tells us. Yeah. Actually, regardless of what we're willing to feel, there's this amazing display happening in our world. And then there's just something about coming into relationship with that, showing up for our world and letting ourselves be moved by our world. And the thing is, we cannot, the cost of trying to freeze something, we can't just freeze like only certain parts of our sensing without it having a general freezing effect on us. We can be in choice about giving ourselves space and permission to not force ourselves to open the heart or open the body like with a crowbar. You know, we don't have to wrench the body open. So we can be sensitive. I think it's very different, freezing versus being sensitive and giving ourselves like the pace of the breath in which to be with our feeling is very different. Yeah. So this one is like sensitively being with the body and what we're feeling. And the other one is actually in a way trying not to feel. So it's quite different. So I want to invite us into being able to come into the feeling body at this time in a way that's sensitive and wise to what's helpful there. Appreciating there might be reasons why certain parts are a bit more protected, and not trying to rip those open, but actually even just being with, okay, I feel that like sensitivity there. Yeah. And okay. Yes. I get to be with that in a way that I appreciate that. Yeah. So in a way we soften into the places where there might be tightening. And you can try this now, just as an example, like, can imagine like one way to do it is you can imagine this like a shoulder creeping up, right? Like, so sometimes I hold tension in my shoulder, so you can let one shoulder creep up if that feels like that's available. Not so much that you're wrenching your neck, but let's say the shoulder's tense, and so I might mimic that. Yeah. And I could take a hand and I could try to force the shoulder down, right? So if the shoulder's tense because it's like worried, and I try to force that down, you can imagine, you can sort of feel into what it's like to try to force an opening or force a relaxation. I don't know what you feel, but there's like a, I feel a struggle here. Yeah, like I actually feel my shoulders getting tenser as I try to force it to relax. Yeah. Anyone can unmute, let's say, and let's hear like a few other observations. It's okay if your voices overlap. Just unmute and say what you notice. Or you can chat it.
Notice tension builds up elsewhere.
Ah, right. Tension is building up elsewhere.
It's painful.
It's painful.
Holding on even tighter.
Say that again?
Holding on even tighter.
Holding on even tighter. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so we get curious. Let's do the same thing, but with the hand. Let's just support. So the shoulder's trying to be like, I want to protect something. With this hand, we can imagine a tension that actually supports that contraction. Yes, it actually moves in the direction of the, sort of supports the shoulder to go up, not pushing it, but just the shoulders up. And I just have a hand that's like, okay, you can do that. You know, I see you, I feel you. And yeah, just blending with that contraction. Not trying to force it to do anything. Maybe the breath is also blending with the contraction. What do we notice? Can I unmute?
Immediately let go.
Ah, immediately let go.
Yeah, it softens by itself then.
Mm. Feels soothing.
Soothing. Yeah.
This is not so, wasn't as exhausting.
Not as exhausting, did you say?
Yeah.
I was holding my breath.
You're holding your breath, yeah. So what if the breath even blends with, yeah.
When I was doing this, right? But that was the hand coming across. Yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, we can even remove the hand and have a blend with just the breath. Yeah. Okay, so there's no one right way here. We're getting curious about what happens, but I would say the principle is, what's it like not to be in a battle with what's happening and just soften into that experience? Yeah, not trying to force ourselves to have the right bodily experience. Calm, loving, whatever we think is the right one, and just come into relationship. I think Balajit said receiving the body as it is. Yeah, that's what we're going to be practicing and just getting curious about that. So we're going to do that by moving through, the energy centers of the body, and we're going to do it a little bit more actively. So I'll do a round of that. And then Balajit's going to do a round that's a little bit less external movement or movement of the voice, because we'll use a little humming and a little actual movement when I'm leading us. And Balajit will lead us in a version where there might be more subtle noticing. And both are fantastically just what they are. All right, so before we do that, I'm just aware of, we maybe just want a little refresher of movement. So just take a moment just to notice and make yourself comfortable. We'll probably do this, you can do this sitting or lying down, and it'll be about, I think we're gonna do this in about 10 minutes. Yeah, at the most 15. Okay, so Singhashri, could you share the slide of the showing the chakras of the body? And we can keep that up for people during this.
Sorry, I had it up and then I lost it, so it's going to take me a minute to find it.
Yeah. So we're going to move through different energy centers of the body. And those are represented by the chakras, the chakra centers. So chakra is just a word from the Indian yoga traditions, using embodied practice. And it refers to an energy center. Yeah, so they run along the core of the body, the ones we'll be working with. And we'll be starting with the base of the body, so the often associated with earth. The legs, the base of the posture. Yeah, so you'll see a picture. Some of this is also represented in the shape of what's traditionally seen as a stupa. So we have the earth, and this, what the word is inside this picture is a seed syllable. So there's a sound that's sometimes chanted with that earth energy, za. Yeah. And we're in this one, the body, we can use this invitation to make sound lower in the body. So it could be the seed syllable za, like that. But I'm going to also invite us, if you want, just to hum, just use humming and vibration to say hello to this part of the body, the lower part of the body, earth, the pelvis and the legs. Yeah. So while we're doing this, we're inviting awareness to come with the sound into the part of the body that we'll be exploring. And just to let that vibration refresh and bring back that sense of aliveness, coming into the feeling aliveness of that part of the body, just as much as feels good. So if you find something that's contracted, you don't have to, again, open it forcefully, but you can maybe let the sound soothe that part of you. It might be welcome for some movement. And I'm going to even invite, if you want a little physical movement, like so in my legs, I might do a little rocking. Yeah. And then just sort of let for moments, maybe just let that settle and just sort of feel what that does for bringing aliveness to the legs. We'll move up to the belly or the navel, and I'll lead us through the rest of them as we go. But we'll spend a little time with each energy center. The invitation is to use sound and to use our awareness, maybe even touch. You can use your hands, like you could be rubbing your legs a little bit, and it's like we're just resuscitating ourselves. Yeah. Bringing ourselves back to life, remembering mindfulness, remembering our bodies. Yeah. So we'll go through each energy center. So I think that's all I'll say, and we'll just do it. Yeah. Okay. So as we're doing the humming or the chanting, I'm going to ask that we go on mute, because I think the sound gets quite choppy. So you can do it. I think Sangadara can help put everyone on mute. You can mute yourself. And then that way you can hum or chant as loudly or quietly as you want, and it's just your own business. Okay. All right, so you can be sitting, lying down in a chair, in meditation, your traditional meditation posture, all good. You can actually even be standing too, that helps. Yeah. Give me a thumbs up if you feel like you got enough to get going. It's going to be a little, you can do that visually if you want, or you can use your emoji. Yeah, got enough to get in there. Yeah. All right, I'm seeing some thumbs. So that means we're somewhere in the game. All right. My friends, so just feeling, you might want to actually feel the contact with the floor, and whatever's in contact with the floor, most in contact with gravity, could be the floor, could be what you're sitting on. Just, you might give that a little rock. So it could be the soles of your feet. It could be the pelvis, sitting bones, and just beginning to actually, notice how you feel the earth. Okay, so we're going to try the seed syllable za, or just humming. So I'll say, and we'll just keep doing it for a little bit, rolling, and you can be quiet for moments if you want to just feel more. And we're feeling into and resuscitating the pelvis and legs. Okay, so The seed syllables ah, humming. Low in the body, za. Might be a hum. Feeling into any resonance in the legs, like awareness dropping right down into the legs, as if the legs were aware what it's like, it feels like sensation, temperature, heat, vibration. Pelvis. Energy of earth. Coming into the belly. Low back and the seed syllable ram, ram. It's also a place of energy of water traditionally. So coming into flow, yeah. Energy of flow. And there might be some swaying movements here, yeah. In the belly, ram, ram. Ram. If you notice frozen spots, stuck spots in the belly, that would welcome some swaying or rocking to bring that water-like flow into the belly. Into the lower back, yeah. Bigger movements, smaller movements. Yeah, again, hands can come to the belly and there can even be a little massaging. Coming to the heart. It felt quite nice to give the heart a little rub. You can imagine support at the back of the heart. And the seed syllables free. And we're bringing warmth or the fire element alive in the heart. Yeah, so our hearts can get quite, it can sometimes be quite cold in there. It can be a cold world. Yeah, so just letting there be some warmth, maybe like blowing on the embers of the heart with the seed syllable Hri humming in the heart center. Yeah. Hri. Singing a little love into the heart. Humming. Or any other words the heart wants to hear. Yeah, healing love in the heart. Space, feeling. Healing. Hello, heart. Hello, hearts. Coming to the throat. Oh, so much said, unsaid in the throat. Yeah, so much swallowing. So it might take a few swallows to feel the throat. You might swallow. The neck, there might be some touch the neck welcomes. Yeah, some movement the neck welcomes. Seed syllable om, expansive air movement in the throat. Just remembering to breathe. Om. Om. Making your own sounds, healing sounds, soothing sounds in the throat. You might notice whether high sounds or low sounds feel good in the throat. Air, expansive, healing qualities of air, the actual air nourishing us. I'm feeling the crown. So maybe the scalp wants a little massaging. Yeah, you can bring our hands to the scalp. Just if there's any touch that feels good. It can be quite nice to go between the eyebrows and just rub out towards the temples. Yeah. And iron the jaw down. So from below the cheekbones, it can be quite nice to iron down the jaw. Movement in the jaw, wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Like we're chewing gum, big wad of gum. Yeah. So the space element, it's just a shake loose in the head, right? So this, and also encompasses the whole body, the space of the whole body. Also the space element can get, be held close, or we can also notice it more expansively, like the sky, yeah, deep space. So we're gonna use ah, or any other humming sound that feels good. Space element, the crown, and releasing to encompass the whole body. Ah, or maybe more soothingly, ah, finding the ah that wants to happen. Ah, decontracting. Giving the body space to feel. Ah. And in the subtlest sense, all that space, just allowing, receiving all the sensations of aliveness that want to be known. Just taking it at the pace of breath, coming in and out as we're able. Ah. A space of feeling, a space of welcoming, coming home to this body. Embedded in the elements of our world. All the other forms we're connected to. Beings of the earth, beings of the water. Beings that live in warmth, the energy of fire. Connected to the beings of the air. The energies of clouds and birds. All of us given the space to unfold. Expressions of aliveness. So we're going to invite you to have a little stretch and movement. Just gently in your own way. You can begin to have a wiggle and just notice again, orienting to your environment, what it feels like to be embodied in your space. Noticing what it's like now to see visual cues or perhaps hear sound cues around you, or any of the senses that are most available to you. So we have a little gift for you, a little gift of resourcing next, which is going to be a body scan, which you can do lying down. Yes, we're going to kind of, in a way, come through the body again, but in a way that's less sound and movement and more subtle energy. And Balajit's going to lead that. So if there's anything you want to get as we have this little movement stretch for, say, a couple minutes, you know, if you want to get some mats to lie on or move to your bed or get yourself cozy in any other way, please go ahead. Yes, we'll take a couple minutes for that. And Balajit will lead us in a scan to close us out for this session. Yeah? That give people what they need, all right.
Okay, so thank you, Viveka. For that journey through our chakras, our energetic and emotional centers. So just as some of you finish setting up, I'll just introduce this practice. So we've got a 20-minute period now, and I'm going to guide us in a body scan. And it's going to have a certain pace, this body scan. So some of you may be less familiar with a faster body scan. So the invitation is to sense and open to the felt sense of different parts of your body that I'll be leading us to. But we'll be moving through the body quite quickly, and part of the reason for this is to support in keeping attention on the felt sense of the body. So there won't be many spells where we're just quiet. So you may well drift off at times, may well go into thinking. And once you notice that, the invitation is to just see if you can pick up where we are in the body, and seeing if you can consciously continue the felt touring across your body. So as ever, just checking you can breathe freely and your head's got good support. For those of us lying down, we have this really strong relationship with the earth element across the whole back plane of our body. And our hearts pointing towards the vastness of the sky above. So this is a practice that can be conducive to connection with the body. Sometimes it's said connection is the deepest longing, but also the deepest fear. So if you start to feel a little bit anxious, or you start to feel a little bit spacey, do feel free to open your eyes and maybe sit up. If it feels a bit too much to directly sense the body. And to pick up on what Viveka said, what's it like to not be in a battle with what's happening? So we have that as an ideal to hold. And then the reality of the karmic momentum of our habits and the tension, inevitable tension between the two. So as we move towards the start of the practice, at the end, I'll just ring the bell 3 times and then we'll end this evening's session. So you're obviously welcome to just continue in the posture. And then we'll meet for the first session tomorrow. So I invite you now just to feel the whole back plane of your body in contact with what's beneath you. And if you're on a chair, feeling the support of the chair against your back. So sensing down into the feeling life of your body. Feeling the contact of the back of your body, back of the feet, the legs, the buttocks, the back and the head. feeling the fullness of this contact with the ground. Generously holding you here in stillness. Becoming aware now of your tongue. Can you feel your tongue? Feeling the tip of the tongue. Can you feel your lower row of teeth? Your upper row of teeth? The left inside wall of the mouth. The right inside wall of your mouth. Becoming aware now of your left ear. As sensation, can you feel your left ear? And if the sense is there is just numbness, can you just experience the numbness just as it is? As we move now to explore the right ear as sensation, and now feeling both ears together. Becoming aware now of the left shoulder as sensation. Can you feel the movement of the left shoulder with the movement of the breath? Can you feel how the left shoulder is subtly moving from the breath? Feeling that subtle movement. Sensing now the left upper arm, radiant sensation. The left elbow, the left lower arm, the left wrist, and now the left palm. So the energy body can be quite tangible here. So my invitation here is to sense any life you can feel in the left palm. Our prana, our life force. Often has a dancing quality to it. Can you sense life in the left palm? As we now connect with the left thumb as sensation, the first finger, the middle finger, the ring finger and the little finger. Sensing now the whole of the left arm, its hands and fingers. What is my left arm, hand and fingers like as an experience? outside of thoughts and images. As we now move across to open to the life of the right shoulder. And again here, can you sense any movement with the breath? Feeling the right upper arm. The right elbow. The lower right arm. The right wrist. The right palm of the hand. And again, the invitation here is to pause as we sense the energy body aspect here. So can you feel any dancing sensations? Sometimes they're like winds of energy. It's a very sensitive part. As we move on now to the right thumb, the first finger, the middle finger, the fourth finger, and then the little finger. Feeling now the whole of the right arm, hand, and fingers together. As vibrant sensation, perhaps with patches of numbness. As we now feel both arms, hands, and fingers together, aliveness. And so from here now, the invitation is to gently move to the belly. So here we land in one of our main feeling centers. And if this feels too much, you might like to just move to the edges of what feels difficult. See if there's a more tolerable edge. So here we may be more likely to be in a felt direct contact with emotional weather. As well as the energetic currents and pulses and tingles. Center of our harbor and solar plexus. And then from there, gently moving up and opening to the felt sense of the heart and chest. And again, if this feels too much, just going to the edges. It's the felt quality of this area in and of itself. As we practice opening to our being in the freshness of each moment, the uniqueness of each moment. And then from here, becoming aware of the whole hips, buttocks, genital area as raw sensation. Seeing if we can meet the body just as it's presenting. Allowing tension to be just as it is. Allowing any ease to be just as it is. And everything in between. And now feeling down into the upper and the lower leg and the knee on the left side and the foot and its toes. So feeling the whole of your left leg and feet and toes. Alive with sensation. And maybe in parts alive with numbness. Or no sensation, but felt as such. And now dropping the left leg and seeing if you can open now to the felt sense of the right leg, knee, feet, and toes. Ceaseless flow of sensations. Flickering at great speed, like the sun on a lake, shimmer. And now feeling the whole of the lower body. And now for the last couple of minutes, sensitive to the whole body as it breathes. Sensitive to your whole body as it breathes. Just this. Feeling. Change. Flow. Mystery. So in a minute, I'll ring the gong to mark the end of this session. May all gods protect you. May all blessings be yours.